Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to learn how to create a 2D drawing with the help of 3D model. In last lecture we created this one, so let's start to see how to make this beautiful 2D drawing. This is the exercise number 83 we created in our last lecture. Now today we will try to create a 2D drawing with the help of this. So here we will learn some basic tools in 2D drawings, how to create a 2D drawing. So here we have two options: either you can drop down the file menu, click drawing from part, or even though you will find one option here, create drawing from parts, or simply just click exit and go to file, select new, and here choose drawing. Now once you click drawing, it will ask you which size of sheet do you like. So this is the standard size. If you uncheck, you will get multiple number of size, so I'll always show a standard format, ISO A3 size. This is standard size. Okay, now once you select okay, see, it will ask you mold view. You can simply click browse and drag your part. Even though there is one more option, standard 3 view. If you choose this one also, you will get directly placed 3 view. So the basic thing, we are going to use model view, browse. Let me choose exercise 83. Now here it is asking you to place anywhere, so let me choose placed here. This is the front view. Now simply select escape key. Now click this one, and we have to, this, it seems smaller, come down, and here you can change the display style. So we will keep hidden lines visible. Now see, the inside lines are easily visible. Now this size is too small. Custom scale, if you go beyond 5:1, there is 10:1, and it seems too big. So we have one more option. If you comes up user defined root, let me save this one, 8:1. This is also big, 6:1. This is seems little good. Okay, now if you like to keep, the next option is projected view. So select projected view, simply select this, already we selected. See, view, you can drag and drop left hand side view, right hand side view, top view, and even though isometric view also you can create with the help of this. So here we will create one top view, and let's say one isometric view. Click OK. Now simply click on the view, drag it. Now for this one, for isometric view, you can select shaded view, so it looks real view. Keep quality here high, so your drawing look more sharper. And scale we will keep parental, no need to define. Even though if you want to change, you can change it simply from here, user defined root. Dimensions projected and everything same. Okay, now let's talk about this. So here if we click this one, and okay, let's, we will talk for dimension later. The auxiliary view, we don't need auxiliary view here, section view. So let me choose section view. If you click section view, here you will see cutting lines. There are four types of section view. So anywhere you will place, the first one we selected, this one is vertical. So we want to define a vertical, but it is difficult to define a center point. Cancel. Now here we will use one tool. If you go to annotation, here you will find center mark and center line. So I'll choose center line. Now here I'll define 1, 2. Now see, the center line is come. Click this one, drag it. That's fine. Okay, then let's try section view. Now this is the our center line, so just click on the center line and drag it, and you will see this is the section view we are going to create. Now see here, even though you can change the label A, B, whatever like, but this is our first section view, so we will keep as it is. Hatching line everything by default, so we will keep as it is. And dimensions we will allocate, so no need to define from here. And okay, this hidden line removed, so that we will get a perfect inside shape here. If you direct double click on this edge section, so here from here you can change 0.5, even though you can select 2, see the higher the gap reduced, but 1 millimeter is standard, so we will keep as it is. Now it's time to okay, broken view we will apply later, this all view we will apply, let's apply dimension. If you directly click on this, and here you will get one option, import options. So if you click import annotations, dimension annotation, see all the dimensions appear, whatever you like, dimension export annotation, include item from hidden feature, see the hidden line also visible, which is hidden inside. Now let's arrange it properly. This one we don't need. Just arrange according to your reading ability. Now here no need to define two dimensions. One is enough, even though you can take it out. And this is the 3 millimeter distance, cutting distance. Now this is the one way you can define. The other way, let me apply for this. Simply go to annotation, choose the smart dimension. Here we are not going to do auto dimension, we are going to apply manually. So this is your first rectangle radius, second radius, and the third radius. Okay, this is shown a diameter. If you want to change those things, you can do it. From here you can click radius, see it is changed radius. See, in a simple way you can change the annotation, like in either in diameter or radius. So this is the simple way you can adjust according to your requirement. Okay, now again smart dimension, let me define this one. This inside diameter, okay. Now here we want to define the angle, so for angle just go to sketch. Let me choose center line, and I'll start draw a center line from here to vertical line. Now smart dimension, angle, degree. Okay, now see the angle also we defined 30 degree. And here one more distance, this is the important distance, 6.5 millimeter long. Okay, now let define this radius, this inside radius. Okay, this is mirror component, so no need to define anything, and rest all we defined here. Now let's come to this is the last option. First the overall length 9 millimeter, and this inside gap, and this is, let's keep inside. (1.6 millimeter). Okay, so this is how we defined it. Even though if you want to increase this options, let's see, manual, use document font, and from here we can change, or let's say bold 5. See, it is bold and 5. So this is how we simply created. Now let's see one more option here, detailed view. Detailed view, either you have to simply go to sketch, spline, and let's create a spline, connect, and go to feature here, select detailed view. Once you select detailed view, you will see a preview. Just let me press somewhere here. Now here we have two options, either see here it is selected profile, because we created a manual profile with the help of spline command. Either if you want to choose select circle, simply select circle. Now it's become circle, even though you can reduce or extrude. Here you can choose broken circle, so that you will get a perfect broken edge. Now dimensions, if you want to allocate dimensions from here, it will, see, we selected and it will allocate all the dimensions manually, no need to define. Now let's do one thing, little change the position so that you will get a perfect shape. Drag it little here. Okay, that's fine. Now we have a space for this. Now this is undefined. Okay, we forget to define one important dimension, and that is center to center. And this is 14.2 millimeter. Okay, let's come to this. Dimension, and this gap also we defined in geometry 1 millimeter. See, if you want to change the scale for this, you have to simply come down, select the sketch, and user defined. This is 12, so let's say 10 by rest to 1. Now see, it is smaller. That's it. Now let's try to accommodate somewhere in good position. This is the proper. I'll select this one. Font I'll make bigger. 4 millimeter bold. See, now here only we have one drawing, so no need to use balloon command. Otherwise you can define simply balloon. Now here we have too many options. Here we selected item number, even though you can choose quantity, part name, everything, but most of the time we use quantity, part number. Okay, so this is the simple drawing. If you like to edit this one, let's right click, edit sheet metal. Now see, we are in edit mode. If you comes in edit mode, everything will be wipe out or hidden. Double click and you will get an option to write something here. So we will write exercise 83. close, click somewhere and you will get. And many things you can write, it is up to you. Even though right click for exit of the edit sketch, simply edit sketch, or simply select here one arrow, you will see this arrow exit. And once you click exit, you will see this drawing. So this is the simple tutorial. If you want to save this in PDF format, simply go to save as, here choose PDF format, see, and choose your destination wherever you like, save. Once you click save, it's trying to take few seconds and it will save in your destination. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.